Yes, many of the star players like Shaquille O'Neal and Kobe Bryant, Kevin Garnett, Jason Kidd, Ray Allen were scratches.
For sure, there are a host of guys that are really good players, but when you look out here, you can't tell me that Andre Miller and David Sean Mary and Elton Brand, you got Jermaine O'Neal and guys sitting on the bench that are tremendous also, so it's a formidable team no matter who you have out here.
You go back to 1980, you were a member of that Olympic team, and that team didn't get a chance.
Mike, don't hurt me. Keep reminding me of that, of course. I mean, I was a starter in the 1980 Olympic team, and you talk about the Russians being in Afghanistan. It really hurt us, but it was a special time in my life to be on an Olympic basketball team.
And when you finally heard the news that you were not going, what was the reaction for you?
I think for all of us, we were just sadly disappointed that you got a cross between the sporting world and politics for the first hit us so hard. But I think the rest of us just tried to take that on and be the best possible pros that we possibly could be. But a lot of people were hurt during those times.
Coming up on 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter, in the United States with a 71-43 lead. Like Brand got a piece of it. Farid Belhamer able to score, and it's a 71-43 advantage. Elton Brand right back. Elton Brand with 17 points on 8-for-8 shooting.
Well, anytime the ball goes into a low post player right now, you see the five green jerseys collapse on him as the 2-on-1 break takes place. Davis throws it up there, and Marion is one guy who can go and get it and finish it. We're going back to what I said. The U.S. is going to face a lot of inside-outside stuff with teams collapsing on their inside people, forcing them to make shots from the outside.
I think anytime you go up against a zone, a U.S. team, and a team that's been together, like I said before, Yugoslavia, the Spain, those types of teams, they've got to make sure and be able to get over the zone and be able to play at the end of basketball games, because against Yugoslavia in a nip-and-tuck game at the end, you've got pros going against pros, and that's going to be a tough time.
This is Bougadir trying to give it up, and a foul is called.
If there's a weakness in the United States team, what do you see out here, Orlando? What's one of the maybe one or two points that you might try to attack versus this particular team?
I think the important factor is that they do really try to play one-on-one basketball. I think right now the help defense isn't there yet, as far as I'm concerned, from what I've seen all throughout. And you've got to be able to have some good continuity with that, and guys playing together and knowing when to relieve, when to help. And I think in playing one-on-one basketball, it gives an opportunity to a guy, just like our team, a chance to go one-on-one and do a good job. So that's the main thing. They need to be able to come together here pretty quick, because they're going to be playing against some teams that have been together for years.
This team only had 11 practices, 3 shoot-arounds, 2 exhibition games coming into this.
Just because they know the game very well, that'll bear out, because they're very talented. But in the nip-and-tuck game, they're going to have to be sharp.
Oh, Andre Miller coming up short. On the reverse, they get the new 24. Miller twisting his way. And the United States extends to the 77-47 lead.
Well, Orlando, did you ever have a Spalding? You know what Spalding
is? Yes, he does. Oh, he's a Brooklyn guy. Come on.
I played my stick ball. Of course, I had my ball out there, and I had my notes from the people that I beat in the neighborhood.
What would you think about a person who carries one with him on the road all the time?
I think it's wonderful. You're talking about sparking some memory.
Thank you so much.
Goodness. Wow. The high bounce ball, too. Boy, this is wonderful. Wonderful. Did you beat anybody, though, with any of the pictures with the ball?
It's dirty. You can tell it's been used. This is a person that sits in his hotel room and bounces it off the wall or ceiling.
Got to get out.
There it is.
That's wonderful, too. That brings up a lot of memories, too, boy.
Don't forget, Rolando.
That's an East Coast activity.
From Grady High School in Brooklyn. He knows Spalding.
Definitely so. He's Flatbush.
Final seconds of the quarter. And Baron Davis able to take it all the way.
After the steal, Baron Davis started the break, had the presence to look up at the clock, notice how much time was left, and finished it off in time before the clock went off.
Rolando, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
Pleasure, Mark. Thanks, Mike.
Thank you, Ralph.
It's a pleasure.
Rolando Blackman, assistant coach for the Dallas Mavericks and for the possible to stop. United States, 54% shooting through three quarters, 32 out of 59. Algeria just 33% from the field. U.S. has its biggest lead of the night, up by 32. Czar, as a point of information, the U.S. largest margin of victory in an international game, 79 points in the 1992 tournament of the Americas. They defeated Cuba 136-57. This will not hit that mark, but we were ready with the information after watching the Algeria workout.
Was that out in Portland? Was that the,
yes, it was. Yes.
Was out in Portland.
A double team Wallace. And back comes Algeria. The point guard Duval. Duval and Bendouzadan in the backcourt. Pressure here by Baron Davis. Ended up down with the shot clock running down. Tried to go glass and went high off glass, and then it's deflected out of bounds.
You don't realize the size of Baron Davis. He's very, very strong. He's 225 pounds, and he's leaning on him. He has three steals. He has great hands.
That time, Ben would have gone, not able to hit the three, and a foul is called. It's on Algeria. It is on Yucic. Tariq Yucic commits number four. It's Michael Finley who just checked back in. So Finley is on the floor with Wallace, Marion, O'Neal, and Baron Davis. Here's the alley-oop for Marion. Will not count. Foul before the shot attempt against the U.S. It's on Jermaine O'Neal, a push-out call.
United States tried to screen the back line man of the zone, and then they sent Sean Marion to the rim from there. That's where the lob pass was attempted, but illegal screen that time, called on the USA.
It's under 9 minutes remaining in this fourth quarter off the rejection. And Wallace puts it down! Serving up a facial, and the U.S. now leads 81-47. Let's go over to Craig Sager. Craig?
Oh, thank you, Mark. We mentioned in 1992, FIBA allowed NBA players to compete internationally. Since then, the United States, a record of 53-0. But there's still college representation. Nick Collison in Kansas, the All-American, representing all colleges as an alternate on this team. What has it meant to you?
It's been a great experience. I've got to practice every practice with these guys. You know, just like they do. They treat like a regular teammate and learn a lot from a lot of experienced players. It's been fun.
What have practices been like? Have they been fun? Have they been all-star practices? Have they been hardworking?
They've been hard work. Coach Carl's trying to get it where it's a playoff-type atmosphere. It feels like if we come out and play with that type of intensity that they do in playoff games, then, you know, we should have a good shot winning the goal. But if we come out and play like an all-star atmosphere, you know, they're in a lot of trouble. So it's been pretty intense.
Do the players talk about the possibility of having an upset or teams playing them tough like Yugoslavia, Argentina?
No, I think they have a lot of respect for a lot of teams, and they know they're going to have to come to play. But, you know, they're just trying to get themselves ready, you know, get as good as they possibly can so they can play their best basketball and hopefully win. But they respect a lot of these teams, and they realize they're going to have to come to play.
You mentioned what a great thrill it was for you to practice with these guys, the NBA players. You also got to play in a couple of games. What will that do to your career and help you at Kansas?
Well, it helped a lot in just in my confidence. You know, I've gone up against some of the best players the NBA has to offer, and I've learned a little bit about the NBA game. And, you know, I'll just go back to school and work hard with my Kansas teammates and get ready to go for the season. I think it'll help a lot, though.
You got to go against Yao Ming in China last week. What do you think of Yao Ming?
He's pretty good. I was impressed. I hadn't seen him. You know, I was anxious to see how he do. But he's got a lot of skills, and he's big, 7'6". I've never seen anybody like that out on the court.
Well, Rock Chalk Jayhawk, see you this year.
All right, see you.
All right, Craig Sager with Nick Collison, an alternate on the team, the only collegiate player on the U.S. squad going into his senior year at Kansas.
The assistant coaches are very impressed with his work ethic and practice. No agenda other than he just comes to play every day, does what they ask him to do. They say he really fits in well with this group.
Williams checking back in. He'll be in the backcourt now with Baron Davis up front. Ben Wallace, Rafe LaFrance, and Michael Finley. The United States with an 85-53 advantage against Algeria.
Who spoke? Who spoke?
through ball being played by Williams. Endadon, who has got a handful tonight, hitting the threes. He has 6 from downtown. That time is blocked by Finley. Endadon has 22 points.
He doesn't hesitate to pull the trigger. They come down 2-on-1 situation, fast break, whereas you might think, let's go for the layup. He goes right to the three-point line and fires it.
Finley has about 4 inches on Endadon. He's trying to take him off the dribble and flipped it down low.
Probably the reason why he's such a great shooter, because he doesn't pass very well.
Jay Williams able to finish 87-53. And Algeria looking for a timeout.
Coach must call the timeout in international competition. It comes when the next dead ball takes place.
Finley with a nice lead. Williams trying to return it. And it's a 2-on-1 led by Yukin. He goes right at Williams and is called for the charge. Anthony Williams taking the hit from Tariq Yukin. And now the timeout is called with 6 minutes remaining in the game. And the United States up 87-53.
The paint. Plus 18 in the rebound category.
Elton Brand leading the way, 8 of 8 from the field. Williams had it batted away. The U.S. will have 14 on the shot clock.
The United States will see a little more size tomorrow night when they play Germany. They have 2 7-footers. They have Dirk Nowitzki, who's 6'11" on the floor. So there will be a different challenge for them tomorrow night against Germany.
Crowd has been chanting for Reggie Miller. He is in uniform, Aaron Davis from downtown, but we were told prior to the game that he would not play because of that sprained ankle, although he could play if needed and might play tomorrow night against Germany.
We got to look at that ankle. That ankle is a very, very bad sprain. There's much discoloration in it. There's a lot of swelling there yesterday. He just about to put pressure on it yesterday, so I can't imagine that it could have improved that much. That if he went today, he would be very effective. But you know Reggie would play, because that's what he's all about. He wants to be out there playing in these games. But as he said earlier, he has to be smart about this. They're going to need him after these first couple of games.
Williams for 3. And Wallace tried to back tap it, but it carried out of bounds. Reggie Miller suffered the injury last Sunday night in an exhibition game against Germany out in Portland. U.S. played 2 exhibitions as they beat China in a romp and did not have an easy time against Germany. Williams so quick, able to tip it away. LaFrance with the lead. Here's the old Davis lost his balance. Apparently there was a slippery spot on the floor, and Baron Davis comes up hobbling.
Yeah, he's very, very lucky. That could have been a very serious injury if that... That sneaker got caught on the surface. And look at it again. Just as he starts to go up, you'll see right there, his foot gets caught. He doesn't have the ability to elevate, and it's a slight turn right there. The right foot slides along the ground rather than planting and elevating. Very fortunate, Baron Davis.
And it's now Baron Davis of the New Orleans Hornets. Davis getting it to LaFrance, trying to go glass. And Baron, late July, agreed to a 6-year, $84 million contract extension.
Are you comfortable saying New Orleans Hornets?
I'm still getting accustomed to it. And that's a violation. Jay Williams going front court then to the back court. So the ball to Algeria. LaFrance stepping in the lane to come up with the steal. This is almost a backcourt violation on the toss.
Just a guy I want to give the ball to, Ben Wallace, to bring it down the floor.
Here is Finley from downtown. I did broadcast games where the New Orleans Jazz were involved. The New Orleans Hornets, a little rhythm to it. Take a little time. They will be a very good ball club.
They could be. They could really could be an excellent team. And this commitment by Baron Davis and signing the long-term contract, as you mentioned, I think really solidifies that franchise. They've got some good young players to go along with Davis and a couple of veteran guys.
Look at the upcoming schedule. United States facing Germany tomorrow night. Saturday, we'll be back with you right here on TNT, 9 o'clock Eastern Time, as the U.S. goes up against Yao Ming and China. And Monday, another game here on TNT with the opponent to be determined. Depends what happens the next couple of days. 3.5 remaining in the fourth quarter, and the U.S. up by the count of 90-53. Well, Duval sits down. Sofyan Velaya checks back in, so he'll play the point for Algeria. Williams for three. Wallace able to get to it. Nice pass. Wallace to LaFrance. Since the NBA started taking part in international competition, starting with the Dream Team back in 92, the United States has not lost a game, although there have been some close calls. The U.S. Olympic team getting by Lithuania by only 2 points in Sydney. At last year's Goodwill Games in Brisbane, Australia, U.S. was extended to overtime and fortunate to get by Brazil. Last week, that exhibition game with Germany, the German team within 5 points, about 2 minutes to play. So the rest of the world is catching up. We've talked about Yugoslavia and Argentina. Brazil has a good team, so does Germany.
Well, this team is fighting the fact that some people refer to it as the JV team was sent, because you have some very notable names missing. Kobe Bryant's not here, Shaquille O'Neal's not here, Chris Webber, Tracy McGrady. So as a result, you have very good basketball players here. You may not have the great, great individual talent. This team can be very successful by playing together, playing with the intensity that George Karl wants them to play with.
Bougadir working his way on LaFrance, and that is pass broken up. Back comes Finley, protecting the dribble, and takes the three. Yes. Michael Finley with 14 points. United States 95 and Algeria 54. It's their biggest lead of the night. Williams for Davis.
You're seeing a different team out here on the floor right now. You have Baron Davis, you have Jay Williams and Finley going after the ball, putting pressure on it, turning the dribbler, coming from the weak side with rotations, forcing turnovers.
Nice pass from Hyatt to set it up. Was actually said, I'll take the three. Hesitated. That's his third straight from downtown.
That's why George Karl would like to have him coming off the bench, because this guy can explode.
Hyatt not able to hit. A rejection by Wallace. We are coming up on a minute remaining of the game. Williams. Well, he had not been hitting from downtown. He does right there. 103-56. The French call for the foul. We mentioned at the start that the head coach of Algeria, Bill Al-Fayed, said that he told the guys, use this as a learning experience. Enjoy what takes place on the court. I don't know how much they're enjoying it right here.
I think just the opportunity to play against a team like the United States gives them a little sense of confidence for when they go on and play other teams.
As a player on the national team for 9 years, Algeria, located North Africa. It is the second largest country in Africa. It's about three times the size of Texas. And as we mentioned earlier, Fayed telling us that basketball is about the third most popular sport behind soccer and team handball.
But very aware of the NBA. Games are shown there. They watch them quite a bit.
Abdelalim Saya on the line. His first appearance of the night. 103-58 with a minute remaining in the game. LaFrentz able to recover.
A lot of guys could have got an assist on that one. Williams, Wallace, LaFrentz.
Have to go under National Hockey League guidelines where they award a couple of assists.
And stars. And stars.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Good.
You tried to run that one past me, didn't you?
No, not at all.
You didn't think I knew hockey, eh?
Farid Belhama, 18 years old, youngest player on the Algerian team, on the line. Zara, the only two guys who have not played for Algeria. The two that attend college in the United States.
Well, if you name Nabil, you're not getting in the game.
That's right. Nabil. Both are Nabil. Nabil Boudasin and Nabil Mebarki. Now you ask Nabil Mebarki, who plays at Imperial Valley Junior College in California, was it a prerequisite to be named Nabil to be from Algeria and attend school in the United States? He did not appreciate it.
He did. He
told me afterwards he was very upset.
He got a chuckle out of that.
25 seconds remaining.
Like you were told that one of them is in the doghouse with the head.
Yes, that's true.
A little bit of a problem.
All right, here's Finley passing on the three. That's the young man out of Kentucky State. We're told Abdul Kadisa must be deep in the doghouse, not seeing any action here in this blowout. LaFrentz. 110-60. This represents the biggest lead of the game, and that is how it concludes. Some symmetry to that final score.
Well, they may have walked off today, or tonight, I should say, with a 50-point victory, but it will not be this easy in upcoming games. In fact, they better zero right back in for tomorrow night. As you mentioned, it was very close in the exhibition game against Germany not too long ago.
Paul Pierce, Hyman with 22, Elton Brand, 17, Michael Finley with 17. We'll be back in a moment. From downtown. Thanks to our producer, Jay Hoover, our director, Renardo Lowe, statistician, Paul Evans. Coming up next on TNT, V.I. Warshawski on the East Coast, Law and Order out on the West. For Craig Sager and the Czar, Mike Fratello, Marv Albert saying goodnight from Indianapolis.